church, what you expect? A sportscast about your Cowboys or the news?
Anyway, I was just reading in my Hebrew translation of that.
Believe this, Scott. It's Hebrew translation.
That peace is more than quiet. It means prosperity, soundness, friendship. It refers to our covenant relationship with God.
I think of how peaceful it must have been in the stable that night with Joseph and Mary and the animals. And maybe Jesus, he's God with us.
Well, maybe. But they were under Roman rule. That had to be scary. And they came to register for taxes. Where's the prosperity there? And Mary had just given birth to baby Jesus. Then the people started showing up. Like the shepherds, and who knows who else. And the animals mooing and cooing and lowing. I'll bet Joseph wanted to give it a rest.
And that's how it is now. We have wars, violence, poverty, but God's peace is with us, in us.
The Greek word for peace is irene. It means...
There we go again.
It can mean harmony, safety, exemption from war, but for Christians, it always means a tranquil state of the soul, assured of its salvation through Christ.
As we light the second candle of Advent, we ponder peace. Peace no matter what. God's peace in us. The tranquil state of our souls, assured of our salvation through Christ.
Let us pray. Dear Creator God, from whom all good gifts come, we thank you for your assurance in our soul. We breathe in your peace, and it fills us, pours out into our families, our community, and our world, your peace that passes all understanding.